Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Let me help you master voice-controlled dictation on your Mac. Now, there are two different types of dictation on your Mac. One is the relatively simple dictation, often called keyboard dictation. You turn it on by going to System Settings and then to Keyboard. And here you've got a setting for dictation. If you turn this on, you can activate it with a keyboard shortcut and then basically speak a sentence instead of typing it. But you're limited as to what you can do. It's really meant for typing just one sentence at a time or a short message or maybe a paragraph in an email. There's a deeper and more complex form of dictation that's called voice control dictation. And you find that under accessibility and then go down to motor and then voice control. And voice control is a way for you to control your entire Mac with just your voice. But an important part of that is dictating text, and you can use it just for text dictation if you like. Voice control dictation gives you a lot more control and is much better if you need to dictate all of the time or large documents or reply to email messages with many paragraphs. So to enable it, you want to turn it on here. This adds a little button here in the menu bar, and you can select it, and you turn it off by using stop listening, and you turn it on by using start listening. You can customize what it does here in system settings. So for instance, I'm going to turn off hints. I'm going to turn off play sound when command is recognized. I'm going to turn off overlay, and this will kind of optimize it just for dictation, not for the rest of the controls. Then you really want to get used to using this control to start and stop. You could also speak these commands. So for instance, if I start listening, I could say, stop listening. And you could see how it stopped there. It's giving me a little feedback there. Now, when it's not listening, it's like voice control is off, except it's listening for one thing. And that's for me to say, start listening. And you could see how it started listening there. So you can turn it on and off with your voice like that, or use this menu bar option. There's no keyboard shortcut for doing that because voice control assumes that you want to keep your hands off the keyboard. And one of the most important parts of getting dictation to work well has nothing to do with your settings. It has to do with the microphone itself, the actual hardware. The microphone's important, having a good microphone, certainly, but even more important than that is the distance from the microphone to your mouth. And a lot of times we're trying to speak to our Macs for dictation when the microphone is in the body of the Mac, say like a Mac Mini, and it's on the other side of our desk or even under our desk. Fortunately, a lot of people have MacBooks or are using an Apple Studio display, which has a microphone array, and it's usually right in front of you when you're using your Mac. But in other situations, think about where the microphone actually is and how far that is from your mouth. Also, think about every time you've ever seen somebody recording audio, whether it's somebody recording a podcast or a singer on a stage, the microphone is usually right in front of their mouth. You should do the same if you want your Mac to pick up good audio. I'd say half the time that people are having trouble with features like dictation, it's simply because their microphone is too far away. So now the hard part about using voice control dictation is there are a ton of different commands. It's hard to remember them all unless you're just using it all of the time. You could see all of the commands here in system settings by going to commands. There's a button right there, and it will list all these commands here on the left. So to make things easier, I'm going to break everything into sections. And if you could just focus on these sections, you could master the main parts of voice control dictation and then add more commands later on. The five main sets of commands I want to talk about are typing special characters, cursor movement, making selections, actions without selections, and making corrections. So when you have voice control dictation on, you basically just speak and it types. But then if you need something special, like say a punctuation mark, you actually just say the punctuation mark and it tries to use context to figure out that you mean the punctuation mark and not the word. So for instance, the quick brown fox jumps over the lazy dog, period. So you can see there, it gave me a period. You can say other punctuation marks like question mark, comma, semicolon, exclamation point, whatever you want. But probably the most common one that you use is to be able to go to the next line or paragraph by simply saying, new line. Now you can find an official list of all the punctuation marks and different special characters that are supported by searching for commands for dictating text on Mac at Apple's support site. And most of them are fairly obvious as to what to say to get that punctuation mark. If you find these videos valuable, consider joining the more than 2,000 others that support MACMOST at Patreon. You get exclusive content, course discounts, and more. You can read about it at MACMOST.com/Patreon. So next, let's talk about cursor movement. The cursor, of course, is the little blinking line when you're typing text, not to be confused with the pointer, which is what you get when you use your trackpad or mouse to click on something. When you type new text, whether it's with a keyboard or with dictation, it's inserted at the location of the cursor. So it's important to be able to move the cursor around. And you could do that with voice control using the move command and then various modifiers. Move left. Move left by 5 words. Move up 2 lines. Move after brown fox. Move to the beginning. Move to the end. So as you can see, there's a lot of different ways to move the cursor around by word, by line, by sentence, by paragraph. You can use all sorts of different commands like that. One of the most common things you're going to say when doing dictation is move to the end, because as you modify things and correct things and move around, you're often going to be finished with your modifications and then want to continue with your document. So saying move to the end is quite common. You're going to repeat that a lot. But also notice how I was able to say move after or move before, and then something that's in the text, and it will find that in the text and put the cursor there. That's usually the best way to move the cursor around. And look what happens if you say something and it's in the document more than once. You get to choose which one by speaking a number afterwards. Move after document. 2. Next, let's talk about selecting text. When you're using a keyboard and trackpad or mouse, you're often selecting text to either delete it, replace it, copy and paste it, and all that. And you can do the same using voice control. There are many different ways to do it, and it's similar to cursor movement. Select the previous word. Select the previous 3 words. Move up 2 lines. Select this paragraph. Select temporary document. So you can see how with selection, you can just simply name the words that you want to select instead of having to move around and use specific commands like previous 3 words or next 5 words to get the selection right. And once you have a selection, you could say delete that or copy that or even cut that to be able to form an action on that. So for instance, if I wanted to copy this and then go to the end of the document and paste a copy of it, I could do it like this. Copy that. Move to the end. Paste that. So you may have noticed that the word that plays an important part of using voice control dictation. Once you have a selection, you can issue various commands using the word that to affect what is selected. You could also, though, do those same commands usually by just mentioning the words, like this. Replace temporary document with example document. There are a lot of commands that work like this. For instance, you can put quotes or parentheses around something or make it bold. Put quotes around temporary document. Bold temporary document. You could even use words like before and after to insert text. Insert example before temporary document. Insert example after temporary document. Now, the last thing I want to teach you is actually just one command, but it's very versatile. It's the correct command. You say correct and either that, meaning this current selection, or correct and then a group of words that's already there, it will come up with a list of choices of alternatives for that set of words. So you can use it to correct a mistake when dictation didn't understand you, or even a mistake when you've said something, but now you decided you want to change it. Correct, quick brown fox. This comes in very useful in a variety of situations. So many times I hear people having trouble with dictation and not being able to get something that they want, and all they need to do is use the correct command and say correct that or correct and then those words, and then they'll have all these different options that they could choose from, and they could just speak that number and then get what they need. If you're going to learn anything from this tutorial, learn to use that correct command. For instance, in that list of commands I showed you on the webpage before, you should be able to say the phrase Roman numeral and then a number, and it should type out Roman numerals, but it doesn't work. However, you can use correct that to get around it. So watch this series of commands. Roman numeral 23. Correct that. 3. Uppercase that. So you can see there that I used a series of commands to get what I want fairly quickly. The key was using correct that to start with to get a little bit closer. Then I was able to use other commands to get it to appear just like I wanted to. And here are some quick tips to take you a little bit further. If you go back into voice control here and look where it says commands, you've also got vocabulary right next to it. You can add your own words to this. So if they're special words or names or locations, all sorts of things, you can just add them here and it will recognize those and spell them correctly. Also realize that the command undo works with dictation, just like it does if using your keyboard. You'll use this a lot as well. So for instance, I'll type something here and say I'll just decide I don't want to keep it. This is the next sentence, period. Undo that. You can do multiple undo thats, and you can also use redo that as well. Also note that you can combine voice control dictation and typing at the same time. Voice control doesn't turn off your keyboard. So if you're able to type, you can combine typing some things and then speaking other things, or use your keyboard and your mouse and your trackpad to make corrections and changes and move the cursor around if you're more comfortable with that. But then for actually typing long passages, use voice control. You don't have to turn off voice control. You can just leave it on, speak, and type. There's also a spelling mode if you need to spell something that you know it's not going to get correct. You just say spelling mode to go into spelling mode, and then dictation mode to go back into dictation mode. Spelling mode. Capital CHEESMAN. Dictation mode. Park. So if you really want to master voice control dictation on your Mac, my recommendation is to learn those 5 different skills and stick with those. Use the keyboard to make any other changes that you need to, and try not to get frustrated when things don't work right. Once you get the hang of using all of those different commands, then occasionally look for new commands in the list in system settings and add those to your dictation vocabulary. Remember, it's not going to be perfect, but neither is typing on the keyboard. You occasionally mistype, get words wrong, have to correct them there, just like you will with voice control dictation. So stay patient and persistent, and you'll be rewarded in the end with being able to type very quickly and accurately using voice control dictation on your Mac. Hope you found this useful. Thanks for watching. If you liked this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.